Hi, third grade friends. This is Miss Volpe. I teach third grade reading at Juniata Gap. You should see me in the corner of your screen, but I also have my computer screen up here so that I can show you some stuff today. This week, our online ELA lessons are going to be all about poetry, which is our next reading workshop unit. So I thought I'd start off by reading you a poem, and I'm going to ask that you really listen to the way this sounds, because poems read a little bit differently than other stories or nonfiction that we read. So really listen to how it flows, hear some rhymes in there, and enjoy. Good morning, dear students, is the name of this poem, and it is written by Ken Nesbitt. Good morning, dear students, the principal said. Please put down your pencils and go back to bed. Today we will spend the day playing outside, then take the whole school on a carnival ride. We'll learn to eat candy while watching TV, then listen to records and swing from a tree. We'll also be learning to draw on the walls, to scream in the classrooms and run in the halls. So bring in your skateboard, your scooter, your bike. It's time to be different and do what you like. The teachers are going to give you a rest. You don't have to study. There won't be a test. And if you'd prefer for a bit of a change, feel free to go wild and act really strange. Go put on a clown suit and dye your hair green and copy your face on the Xerox machine. Tomorrow it's back to the regular grind. Today, just go crazy. We really don't mind. So tear up your homework. We'll give you an A. Oh, wait, I'm just kidding. It's April Fool's Day. So I thought that poem was perfect for today because we just had April Fool's Day on April 1st. And also, we aren't in the classroom like usual. We're at our homes, and this is a little bit different. And I thought it was pretty funny, too. So what I want to take most of the time today on this video showing you is a website that you will be able to find lots of poems for our whole poetry unit on. Because during these little mini lessons, we're going to ask you to look at some poems here and there. And so this website, there's a large amount of them. So I'm going to go to this new tab here. I'm going to type in the address, and it is poetry, P-O-E-T-R-Y, and then the number 4, and then the word kids, kids.com. And let's take a look at what this looks like here. So if you scroll down, you can see this is Ken Nesbitt, the person who wrote the poem we just read and who wrote all the poems, I believe, on this website. And if you go down here, there's all kinds of categories that you can explore. For example, if you clicked on funny poems, there's things like lessons and games and a rhyming dictionary. If you ever need to write your own poem and you want to come up with a good rhyme, there's a rhyming dictionary. There's all kinds of things here. So for example, if I click right here on funny poems, and scroll down, here's a collection of some funny poems. And the first one right here, as you can see, is Good Morning, Dear Students, the poem that I read to you. And also, if you go back up to the top and go under this little tab here where it says poems, you can see these different kinds of tabs that you can click on. The one that I like, this one says Surprise Me. It's down at the bottom here of this first column. And if you click on that, it just gives you a random poem to read. And I really like that because sometimes you can't decide what kind of poem you want to look at. So this is a poem called What to Remember in School. And also here you can see there's a little play button and it will read it out loud to you, which will be really helpful sometimes. So this week we are going to be asking you to look at some different poetry and respond to some different questions about them. So if you have a notebook at home, you can use that kind of as your poetry journal for the week. Even if you don't have a notebook, just get a couple pieces of paper together and that can be your journal or your poetry journal. We do suggest that you keep a little section available, maybe leave a page for vocabulary. You're going to learn all kinds of words this week that are just to do with poetry. So as we sort of collect those words, we're going to add them to our notebook. So maybe have that ready too. Today's activity. So I wanted to show you also, you're going to also get an activity board that looks something like this that I'm pulling up here. And as you can see, the ELA section is the first column and it gives you a little activity to do with each video lesson for each subject. And so today's, I just thought I'd make it a little bit bigger for you here. Your activity, your assignment today, there we go, is to just explore poetryforkids.com and find 3 poems that you enjoy and share them with someone at home. This could be your parent or a sibling. And I want you to practice reading them out loud with expression. Because as you heard when I read my poem, there's sort of a rhythm that goes along with poems. And so you'll read them a little bit differently, and they're really fun to read. So practice reading them out loud. And that's all you have to do for today's ELA assignment, is just explore that website, find some poems that you like. I hope you have a lot of fun reading this week, and maybe we'll even have you try writing some of your own poetry. And on these videos also, I just wanted to mention, if you ever need to pause them to see something on the screen a little bit longer, you can do that. And the great thing about videos, if you miss something, you can always rewind and hear it again. So thanks for joining me today. Bye for now. Happy reading.